A Futures Past Edition. Audio presentation. The following is a recording of a phone conversation between Stuart J. Byrne and Jean Marie Stine and is copyright 2010 by Futures Past Editions as an imprint of Renaissance eBooks Incorporated and may not be used for commercial purposes without the express permission of the copyright holder. Stuart J. Byrne is one of the most distinguished pulp writers of science fiction's golden age. Byrne has published over 3 million words, mostly cover features for science fiction pulps like Amazing Stories, Other Worlds, Science Stories, and Imagination. Stories like Last Days of Thronus, Beyond the Darkness, Lens, Prometheus 2, and Power Metal, among others, won him plaudits from readers and his fellow authors alike. As the age of the pulps came to an end, Byrne switched to paperback novels, writing genre bestsellers including the Starman series, Thundar, Man of Two Worlds, Hoaxbreaker, and Star Quest. Byrne has also written motion picture and television scripts, ranging from classic TV series like Men Into Space to feature films like The Deserter and The Doomsday Machine. Mr. Byrne holds a BA and an MA with courses covering the gamut of computer technology, electronics, astronomy, and management. He's held jobs in international management, system analysis, multi-country system installation, large-scale procurement, and inventory control management. He is multilingual, speaking English, Spanish, and German, and has lived in South America and Guam, as well as traveling extensively for Litton Industries to NATO bases throughout Europe as principal engineering writer and proposal survey rep. The ebook edition of his masterwork, Star Quest, was the number one science fiction bestseller for over a month on the fictionwise.com website and remained on the ebook bestseller lists for more than 3 months. Music of the Spheres and other science fiction classics, the first ever collection of Stu Byrne's pulp stories, and new editions of his never-before-reprinted pulp novels have also been bestsellers in ebook format. In this interview, Byrne talks about his Michael Flanagan trilogy, his work on the classic 1950s television series Men Into Space, and the creation of his 12-volume Starman series. Stuart J. Byrne's books are available as ebooks through futurespasteditions.com, amazon.com, barnesandnoble.com, and fictionwise.com, as well as other distinguished e-tailers. As we join the conversation, Mr. Byrne is responding to a question about his classic 1950s science fiction pulp magazine series, the Michael Flanagan Trilogy, and the events that gave birth to the adventures of his hero in the land beyond the lens.
Ray Palmer sent me a front cover piece of artwork. He wasn't with Amazing Stories anymore. He was with Other Worlds. But Brown, the editor of Amazing, had sent him the cover and said, write me a story, a feature story around this piece of art. So he sneaked away to me, sent it to me, and said, hey, you write it, and we'll give you the John Bloodstone name, and we'll pretend that I wrote it. And so I wrote The Land Beyond the Lens, because the picture showed a guy who was going through some kind of a lens, so I made the story fit the thing. But when I invented him, then he had a universe that built itself and went on from there, and all of a sudden Brown of Amazing writes back to Ray and says, what the hell are you doing to me? Everybody wants a sequel. So I wrote The Golden Gods. The hero was Michael Flanagan, and he screamed, Brown screamed and said, what are you doing? They want another one. And so I wrote The Return of Michael Flanagan. It became the Flanagan Trilogy by Bloodstone. So at the World Convention in Chicago in 1953, sitting there at a table was Ray Palmer and his wife, and also Brown of Amazing. And finally, Palmer confessed. He said, well, this might spoil your dinner, but I didn't write the Flanagan Trilogy. brown and red, and he said, "Who did?" And he pointed to me, and the guy almost had a fit. I mean, I wasn't a hardcore Asimov. What's his name that wrote The Moon Pool?
Merritt.
Yeah, I was more along that line, and Brown favored hardcore and didn't like further expansions of consciousness, apparently. So I got even with him with the Flanagan trilogy.
Did you leave a hook or a space for a sequel in every story?
Oh, yeah. Edgar Rice Burroughs did that to me. He always had a cliffhanger.
When first published, the first volume of Stuart J. Byrne's classic Michael Flanagan trilogy, written under the pseudonym John Bloodstone, it appeared as a complete novel in the March 1952 issue of the legendary pulp magazine Amazing Stories. Byrne's novel caused a sensation. Hundreds of readers wrote in demanding, "More Flanagan, please!" It took two more Flanagan novels to begin to satisfy readers' hunger. Now, for the first time in more than half a century, read this thrilling, colorful science fiction adventure that captures all the excitement and energy of the classic pulp magazines. Don't miss this visionary trilogy that became increasingly off-trail as it develops and is certain to remind some readers of the work of Jack Vance. Byrne's saga begins when a song calls Michael Flanagan from one world to another. Behind him, Flanagan leaves the woman he loves and who loves him. There, in a primitive world of swords and arrows, with ancient legends of golden gods and lost magic, Flanagan rediscovers his true identity and his lost love, Altenra. When Altenra is captured, Flanagan swears to free her and all the people who dwell in this land beyond the Lens. Flanagan's only hope is his knowledge of Earth weapons like explosives and guns. It is a daring dream that will carry him to victory or death. And does Flanagan really want to live? For if he wins, he will have to choose not merely between two worlds, but between his two loves. Don't miss all three volumes of the electrifying trilogy, The Land Beyond the Lens, The Golden Gods, and The Return of Michael Flanagan. Stuart J. Byrne's Michael Flanagan Trilogy is available in ebook format through its publisher, FuturesPastEditions.com, Amazon.com, BarnesandNoble.com, and FictionWise.com, as well as other distinguished e-tailers.
Do I not remember that you were involved in an early sci-fi television series?
Oh, I wrote some of the Men in the Space thing. Well, starring Bill Lunnigan, that's it. Yeah, he met me in the studio once at the studio bar. And he asked me, "Are you one of the guys that writes this turkey?" And I said, "Yeah." And he said, "Well, how come I can't ever rescue a woman or something in this thing? I'm always fighting elements and nature." And I said, "Well, if I told you, you'd want a pretty stiff drink." He said, "Well, what is it?" I said, "Well, this is under the auspices of the Air Force, and they want everything absolutely accurate. That's why they sent us to San Diego to see the Alpha, the missile system there, and so forth. Everything accurate." And he said, "Well, what's that got to do with what I was saying?" And I said, "Well, they have not yet developed a catheter tube for a woman's spacesuit. Therefore, there are no women in space," so forth. And he says, "Oh, my God, give me a straight whiskey." They hadn't invented a catheter tube for women, so there were no spacesuits for women, therefore no women in the series. You get into some funny circumstances in that movie world.